This will make a huge difference. 10 minutes a day. This is going to put you in power. This is going to put you in control. This is going to put you in a position of momentum and force and energy, and it's going to carry you through to becoming that level 10 version of yourself that you want to become, to attracting the level 10 success, the level 10 relationships, the level 10 health, the level 10 fitness. All of that starts with you taking control in your morning.
Welcome back to the Go Get It podcast. We hope you've had an amazing holiday season and are ready to welcome the new year with some intention, some momentum, and with a whole lot of drive. It seems like this is the time of year everyone gets really excited about doing the things we know we should be doing, but have not quite brought ourselves to do consistently yet. It's when people decide that they are going to get it. But after you've made that decision and commit to start making some changes. Some people call them New Year's resolutions. I don't know what you call them. But after you've committed, how do you know what to do? What's going to make the biggest difference? How do you maximize your personal growth heading into 2021? Well, today, Hunter is going to share a bit about his journey in finding direction. And we'll introduce a process called the Miracle Morning. It is a practice that he and over 500,000 other people do each day to set them up for success. And I'm kind of in your boat as a listener. Hunter's going to be pushing me on this one in this coming year. And so I'm excited to learn from Hunter today and moving forward. And as part of that learning journey that I'm going to be on, we have a New Year's challenge for you all. Yes, a 30-day challenge, and it's for the bold. It's for those who take their word seriously, and when they say they're going to do something, they do it. So if that's not you, if you aren't that person, then you can cut out before the end of the episode where we're going to put forth that challenge. But I have a feeling if you're here, if you're listening to the Go Get It podcast at this point, then you're probably here for a reason. So without further ado, I'm going to pass it to Hunter, who's going to talk about the Miracle Morning and work us through this. Hunt, take it away.
Absolutely. Thank you, Stig. Just want to make a quick note on that 30-day challenge, by the way. We don't wait until Jan 1 to start the challenge. The challenge starts today.
Well put.
We set the tone today.
That's right.
Yeah, so I definitely thank you. Thank you for the lead in there, Stig. And this brings me back to late 2017, early 2018, where that was a very, you know, that was a time in my life where I was like, you know, I'm doing well, but I want to be crushing it. I want to go to another level. I want to start to, you know, really develop myself personally so that I can achieve quote unquote level 10 success. And I started looking for, you know, for ways that I can do that, for a foundation that can be laid to facilitate that. And it was around that time that my brother actually gave me this book called The Miracle Morning.
Okay.
And it was a transformative book for me. Transformative book. And really, really set the stage for me to be able to pursue my personal development on a new level. And I'm going to go through some of the practices in that book, which, you know, this is still a practice that I do to this day. And I think it's going to be great for the listeners just to start to get their wheels turning, get ideas on how they can really maximize, you know, in different areas of their lives. But first, I kind of want to just talk about really quickly why it's important. And I think, and I'm going to read a quote from the book here. You know, he talks about, and it's not just Hal, but other people have talked about something called, like, you know, level 10 success, he calls it. So, okay, you know, you basically write out these different areas of your life and you say, you know, what would level 10 success look like in these different areas? In my health, in my fitness, in my relationships, in my, you know, in my career, all these different things, what would level 10 success look like?
And, you know,
oftentimes everybody wants to achieve level 10 success. And that's why you're starting to, you know, that's why you're starting to say, you know, at the beginning of the new year, I'm going to start doing these things. I'm going to start taking care of my body. I'm going to start making better choices. And so here's let me just read something very quickly here. He says, what you're about to find out is that achieving level 10 success in every area of your life is not only possible, it's simple. It's simply dedicating purposeful time each day to become a level 10 person that is capable of creating, attracting, achieving, and sustaining level 10 success in every area of your life. And the reason why this is so important to me is because I've encountered a lot of people who they miss this. They get this wrong. They think that, you know, when something happens, then they'll start to do the next thing. If you want level 10 success, you need to become a person that is worthy of attracting that level 10 success.
Right.
So it starts with the personal development, and then you can achieve the things you want. It doesn't happen with, I'll achieve the things I want, and then I'll start doing the things I know I should be doing.
Right.
Gotcha. So that's first of all, super critical. That's number one. Number two, before I jump into the practice itself and give you guys a bit of background here, is this. Your level of success will rarely exceed your level of personal development, because success is something you attract by the person you become. So just reiterating that kind of level 10 success that I just kind of touched on there. So let me give a little background on Hal Elrod and the making of this book and why people should even take it seriously. So Hal Elrod, he encountered two ginormous setbacks in his life that led him to the path to discover what is now the Miracle Morning. The first one, at age 20, he actually died. So he was hit head on by a drunk driver at 70 miles per hour. His heart stopped for 6 minutes. He broke 11 bones in his body. He was in a coma. And when he eventually woke from the coma, the doctors told him he would never walk again and he would most likely have permanent brain damage. So that was number one incident in his life. He goes on to actually beat the doctor's prognosis there, actually, you know, ends up running a 52-mile ultra marathon, which you could appreciate and
there we
respect.
Go, Hal.
At some point in his life. But that was sort of the first really tough moments in his life when he had some of that adversity and needed to, you know, deal with his new reality, you know, not deny it, but defy it, as Les Brown always says, and, you know, find his way. Eventually, he does find his way. He starts to become a successful business and salesman and works his way up in a marketing company where he's doing really well, eventually peels off to do some life coaching things and was giving talks and all these different stuff. And around that time, 2007, 2008, when the global financial crisis hit, he was about to get married. He just bought a house. He had all these speaking engagements lined up. And then the world basically crashed because of the global financial situation. And he lost everything. All the speaking engagements got canceled. Nobody was bringing in speakers to do speaking engagements. He was $425,000 in debt, severely, severely depressed, couldn't bring himself to get out of bed anymore, and was contemplating suicide. And it was at that time, he was in a deep depression for a while, and it was at that time that a friend recommended that he start moving his body, start exercising. But really, he started looking for, you know, what is it that all of these successful people are doing that is not only helping them to become successful, but sustaining that and sustaining their happiness over time. And that's when he turned towards research, and he basically found what he calls are the savers. I'm going to get into what the savers are, but it's basically these six proven practices that, at least in some capacity, maybe not all of them, but all of the success, you know, most of the successful people that he's either studied from the past or the present, they practice in some way, shape, or form, you know, at least a few of these principles. And so I'm going to share the principles with you now, and then I would love to hear kind of how you interpret the principles, in what way you're incorporating this into your life. I can tell you how I've been incorporating it into my life. And I think through our discussion here of those six different principles, it will get a lot of wheels turning and give ideas to all of the listeners here on how they can incorporate this into their lives and start to maximize and progress with their personal development. So so with that, it's like I said, the acronym is SAVERS, S-A-V-E-R-S. And he calls them that because this was, you know, these were his life savers. And so I'll hit them all first, and then we could go into them one by one. So the S stands for silence. The second stands for affirmations. The V stands for visualization. The E stands for exercise. The R stands for reading. And the S stands for scribing or writing. And basically, the idea behind it is that he wakes up an hour before he normally would in the morning, and he does 10 minutes in each one of these different areas, and he calls it his miracle morning. And that's what sets him up for the day to be able to go crush it.
It's a very catchy hook, miracle morning.
It's a very catchy hook.
Love that alliteration, huh?
Yeah. And it's not, and so it really has proven to be now, this is, you know, he's written this years ago. This has proven to be a miracle morning for so many people. There's literally a Facebook group that has over 500,000 people subscribed to it that do the miracle morning regularly, mm-hmm. and tons of testimonials that talk about the difference and impact that this is making in their life. And it really is amazing. And I could tell you firsthand what it kind of, what it did for me and what it's continuing to do for me, because I'm still doing it to this day, which is probably a testament to, you know, to how powerful I think it is. So the first one, let's go through these different principles. Let's talk about them, volleying them off each other so we can give some ideas to people and maybe we can learn a little bit more about each other. So the first one is silence. Some people think of this as meditation and, but really to me, I have like a broader view of it. And I interpret this as just any time in which you just take a second to yourself. And so the way that I employ this, I do it two ways, right? And first starting out, I literally just said, okay, you know what? For 1 minute in the morning when I wake up, I'm just going to sit and I'm just going to let my mind go wherever it goes. And I'm just going to kind of sit in silence and I'm not going to, you know, start going yet. I'm just going to take 1 second to relax and just let my mind work, go where it goes. And then eventually it evolved to Headspace is a meditation app. They do guided meditation. They also, you know, just have, they have a lot of amazing content on there. And so eventually I started doing some of that guided meditation stuff, which was awesome for me as well. So I've kind of, you know, dipped into different things here, but each of which has been extremely helpful for me to kind of just slow down. You know how we're always trying to go and get after it. And so it's really useful for me to just let my mind be still for a minute, for 2 minutes, for 3 minutes a day before I, you know, start really getting after it. Do you have anything you do in particular in terms of slowing down or giving yourself some time and space to just be?
Well, like I said at the top of this episode, you know, the employing some of these tactics from the Miracle Morning is going to be a journey for me, starting with the challenge we're going to put forth at the end of this episode. But when I think about my morning routine and when it comes to silence, you know, I gotta say, Hunt, like I do get caught up in what's super easy often is that I wake up and the first thing that's pulling at my attention is my phone, right? The first thing I want to do is like jump on that phone, like see if I have any messages, see what's happening on social media. And actually in the past few weeks has been a time where I have given myself some space to take some of that silence. I've been reading and exploring more about religion and faith. And so one of the things that I've been trying to do in those mornings is take time to breathe, like feel more present, and then even say a few prayers. And that has been like a nice practice for me because it's a challenge that I put forth towards myself. And it's given me space away from like just going straight to my phone and be like, I'm going to take control of this moment right when I wake up. I'm going to take control of the energy that I have myself and the energy that I'm putting back out into the world. And taking some of that silence right when I've been waking up in the morning has been a new challenge that I've been putting forth. And I never really thought about it in the context of savers, but that could be another way that I think about to keeping that going over the next 30 days.
Yeah. And has that made a difference for you? Have you seen, do you like the change that you made? Is there any benefit you see rather than go, you know, getting up and grabbing the phone right away?
Yeah. I think as I'm exploring faith, I think that, you know, prayer is a huge component of that. And so that's also connecting me to God, connecting me to that process, that journey I'm on. So like, that's been a way to reinforce some of the things that I've been reading and actually put it into action, put it into practice. So that's been useful. And then also when you go to your phone, when you go to social media, when you go to the news, one of the things I think about is like, I'm not in control anymore. I'm giving control to whatever the news headline is. I'm giving control to whatever my friend did or whatever my friend posted. And I think that in my life where I do love spontaneity and this unstructured nature of it so much, I continually am seeing the benefit of putting structure towards that morning. And we'll talk about it when we get to exercise because that's really the key for me, or it has been. But having something where I am completely in control of the energy to start the day it just gives me a lot of peace.
Yeah, for sure. And it is like very symbolic for me as well, in terms of just making the conscious decision that I'm not going to go right to my phone and let that snowball start, you know, because we all know how it is when you go to your phone, whether it's checking something for work or whether it's mm-hmm. just checking things on social media, really innocently you go there. But yeah. then, you know, it ends up leaning to so much more than just like, oh, let me just check my email, because then one thing leads to another and then you're into it already. And you didn't have any time to just say, you know what, today's my day. I'm going to kill it today. I'm going to have some intention here and mm-hmm. I'm going to do the things that I know I want to do. Rather than relinquish that control to you know, whoever's on the other side of the phone. That kind of leads, you were kind of touching there into the second letter, which is A for affirmations. You talked a little bit about prayer. So I think that's probably at this stage in your life, what it means, you know, what it means for you, that affirmations piece. I'll share kind of what I do for the affirmations. Mm-hmm. And I think for anybody listening, again, we're just giving you ideas here. You can really take this where you want to go and find the sweet spot for yourself. An affirmation, it could just be something, it could be one sentence that you write out, or that you know, a quote, or it could be a paragraph, or it could be a passage. Mm-hmm. The important thing here with the affirmations is just that you speak it. Obviously, the more powerful, and Austin, you know this, I have some crazy stories with you. Guys, yeah. I've literally had, you know, when we were, you know, we brought other people into this miracle morning, I remember being in a room, four people in the room doing the miracle morning together and shouting at each other, like yeah. screaming at each other. And it does like changes your state completely,
completely
and gets
yeah.
you like jacked up and ready to crush the day.
Yeah. Everyone thinks you're crazy,
everyone thinks you're nuts, but you're like, I don't care, 'cause I'm killing it. Yeah. But if you're not ready for that, it's just about speaking it out into the world. Mm. And this is a huge one for me. And I talk to myself like all the time, just getting jacked up about stuff. What I do, I have a book here. It's called The Greatest Secret in the World. It's by OG Mandino. He's one of my favorite authors. And he has some really like powerful just paragraphs in there. And those are the things that I'll read to kick off my day. But for you, it sounds like recently it's some sort of prayer. Is there anything else kind of predating that or before that?
Yeah.
How does this work out for you in your life?
Yeah, so the way it works out for me in my life as well is I think about my day coming, my day ahead of me. And so oftentimes it's working on a story, whether I'm out in the field or whether I'm editing or I'm usually about to get out on a run, and it's just visualizing how those things are going to go. And affirming that they're going to go great. I kind of use visualization and affirmations.
You're getting ahead of me. You're getting right into the V now, buddy.
I know.
Every single one we do, you're popping to the next one.
They're all wrapped up together. They're all tied for me.
They're all tied to me.
So, you know, usually when I'm just like getting ready for my run, right? I'm like talking myself up. And it's not usually out loud. It's not verbal, which I can try for our 30-day challenge. But usually it's just like, all right, hey, it's going to be a great day. It's going to be an easy day. It's going to be a great day. I'm going to be flying out there. I'm going to be feeling great. I'm going to be feeling strong. I'm going to be feeling fit. And then when it comes to doing the editing and the storytelling, it's the same kind of thing. It's saying to myself that, like, you are one of the best storytellers out there. And I believe that. I believe that. It with all my being, and I'm going to speak that into existence so that I know when I get to my computer later today and I'm putting together a story that I have what it takes to make a story great.
That's amazing. Let me give an example because you gave a very specific example. I'll give an example of like one of the paragraphs that I read here in you know, as one of my affirmations. Mm-hmm. So here's a line. I will persist until I succeed. I was not delivered unto this world in defeat, nor does failure course in my veins. I am not a sheep waiting to be prodded by my shepherd. I am a lion, and I refuse to talk, to walk, to sleep with the sheep. I will hear not those who complain, for their disease is contagious. Let them join the sheep, for the slaughterhouse of failure is not my destiny. I will persist until I succeed.
Hunter literally sends me messages where he goes, I'm a lion. I'm a lion.
So that's an example of just like a paragraph that I would read out loud just as my portion of that kind of affirmations in the morning.
I like it.
Before
nice.
I get into the zone for the day. Cool. So you touched on visualization there briefly.
Yeah.
So let's jump into visualization. I think this is one where a lot of people probably need, you know, a little bit of practice here. And that's exactly what it is. You do just need to experiment with it and just practice over time the technique of visualization. And I know that I was probably introduced to it through sports, through soccer, because that's a thing that you do with sports. Mm-hmm. You visualize, you know, in different aspects of the game and different movements so that you already play it over in your mind before the moment arrives. But it really does transfer into just regular life.
Absolutely. And
if you can visualize these things that you want to achieve, and you can visualize how you're going to feel when you achieve it, or, you know, what that is going to look like for you achieving it, or what it's going to feel like, or what it's going to sound like, the more you can familiarize your brain with that, you know, potential reality, mm-hmm. the more of a reality it actually becomes.
Yeah.
And so for me, I just take a few minutes to just, you know, sit again, visualize, you know, these different moments of the day, exactly what I said now, what it's going to feel like, what I'm going to be seeing, what I'm going to be hearing, these things going well. You mentioned earlier, you know, in a different episode of the Go Get It podcast, a technique that you were introduced to, which is actually envisioning things like not going great, but then you succeeding in spite of that, which I think is brilliant.
Visualizing the imperfect scenario, things going wrong, but then visualizing your perfect reaction to that imperfect scenario.
I love that. And that's going to be a challenge I set forward to myself for these next 30 days is doing a little bit more of that instead of just mm-hmm. doing, like, you know, completely visualizing everything being seamless and going easy. So I think that's great. But is there anything that you do in particular right now? I know that you touched on when you go out for those runs, like what is it that you're visualizing on those runs?
Yeah, I think when my mornings get started these days, like, I'm so quickly getting into my running that when I do the visualization or when I do the affirmations, it doesn't happen in the kind of like linear process of which we're talking about it. You're thinking about
which it doesn't have to, by the way.
Right. Exactly. So what I'm saying is, like, my running is like the rock of the morning. That's the structure. I am almost 1,000 rows with my current coach, like, into a Google spreadsheet of, like, daily running plan. Like, it's the most structured that I ever get in my life is with my morning run. And a lot of these actually happen on that run. So, like, with the type of miles I'm running, you're thinking, like, okay, I'm going to be out there 1.5, 2 hours in the morning. And that gives me a lot of this headspace to have. Like, when you're talking about silence, not only is it like saying a prayer in the morning, I'm literally just out in the woods with no service often for 2 hours. And all
definitely
of that,
getting that
time,
silence in there.
Exactly. That's meditation. That's silence. That's all of it. That's saying the affirmations when I'm feeling tired. Hey, you're not feeling tired, Austin. Like, let's go. You got this. It's visualization. It's visualizing the future races that I want to be in. It's visualizing actually, like, the anatomy of my body, like, literally churning and going and going, and then visualizing what's about to come in the rest of the day. So all of that is tied together for me when I'm running.
Yeah, I think that's a great lead in to the E, which is exercise here. The most important. I'm just going to go say it. The most important.
We believe it. That's for sure.
Getting your body in motion is so, so important just to move. It makes you feel good. It makes you, it releases certain hormones that are amazing for you. But the E for exercise, I think, and doing this early in the morning, the benefits of that are even more because it's not hanging over your head. You feel like you've already gotten into action and you have momentum. I just think that this is so big. And I think the important thing here for people is that it doesn't have to be a marathon in the morning like Austin does. If it is, that's amazing, but it doesn't have to be. It doesn't have to be a full 1.5-hour workout. The important thing, though, is that you get something in and you signal to your body that today we are in action, we are in motion, we are moving, we are doing. And so I think that that's so important, whether it's just, you know, I know people who just do like 30 jumping jacks in the morning or 30 jumps or you know, push-ups, whatever it is, just to signal to the body that it's time to get going. And obviously, you know, you've touched on this quite a bit, but you can expand on it if you want, what this portion of your morning means to you.
Yeah, well, besides the fact that it is kind of the container for which I do all these other categories in the savers, everyone who's listening right now, you've started off the day at some point with just like crushing a workout, crushing some physical activity, or just doing a little bit. And to me, there's just nothing more beneficial to set up my day than that feeling after the workout. You got your blood pumping. You feel accomplished. Multiple of our Go Get It episodes, we've talked about the quick win comeback. We've talked make your beds, those small wins that you need to build momentum. There's no more empowering feeling to me than getting back from a run and just feeling those endorphins coursing through your body. I mean, you feel Absolutely. Like you could take on the world. And so not only is it the container for me, but it literally gives me that feeling that propels me into whatever I'm doing the rest of the day.
I asked Mama Gorsk, you know, when she gets done with her workout, she says, ask me how I feel. I say, how do you feel, Ma? She says, like $1 million. when you're thinking about the exercise portion, you got to think about like how you're going to feel after, not how much, you know, not how much it's going to suck to start. Just chase that feeling that you know you're going to have right when you're done. You have that feeling of self-accomplishment and self-worth there.
Yeah.
That kind of brings us into the next one, which is the R for reading. And reading, this is a pretty self-explanatory one, but you cannot understate how important it is to always be filling your brain and your thoughts with positive, powerful messages. It comes back again in this world we live in with social media and all of these different, you know, outputs that we have and distractions, to take some intentional time to fill your brain with some really positive knowledge. And so I don't know, is there anything in particular that you read that you think could be a good suggestion for people to either get started with, or just things that you find really interesting to read, maybe types of stuff that you like to read? Or
I haven't been reading a lot this year, gotta say that. However,
if you're watching the video, you can see it. You can see the disappointment in himself there, people.
Have not been reading a ton this year. However, if I go back to that exercise being a container, being the bucket for my savers, a lot of times it comes in the form of podcasting for me. It comes into like filling my brain with positive messaging. Like we talk about here on the Go Get It podcast, I have a number of shows that I listen to when I go on my runs. Like one of my favorite is called the Rich Roll podcast. I listen to a lot of podcasts that are about health and fitness and mindset. And so that's kind of the way that I've been thinking about reading for me these days.
There's a powerful teaching that somebody says, that which is that happiness equals growth, or growth equals happiness. And I completely agree with that. And I think that's why it's always important to be learning and to be expanding your mind and your viewpoints and your outlooks. And that to me is why reading is so, so important. Right now I'm reading Getting Everything You Can Out of All You've Got. It's a really good book just about sort of marketing and business stuff. I do like a lot of business related stuff, but I also like a lot of personal growth, self-help stuff. Anything that allows me to expand my mind in some way, shape, or form really feels good to me. And I think that, you know, when you get that done in the morning, again, it just puts you in that state of, I am learning, I am growing, I am becoming more, I am becoming better. Mm-hmm. Last thing I want to touch on here is the S, which stands for scribing, otherwise known as writing. And shortly after I did the Miracle Morning, I got a journal, which was well outside anything I'd ever done before. Probably people would never think I would have got a journal and started writing things in it. And
you
it's
love this
made,
journal.
And I love this journal. So it
goes with you everywhere.
I'll give a plug to the journal. It's called the Panda Planner. It does a whole 6 months at a time. It goes from monthly, weekly, and then daily. But one of the most powerful things that I do there, obviously, you know, I have my tasks, or you know, the priorities for the day. What I really want to focus on here is a section that is just, it has me write down 3 things that I'm grateful for. And I think this could be an immensely beneficial practice for everybody listening when it comes to, in your quote unquote miracle morning, writing down 3 things that you're grateful for. So important to check in and be present and really express gratitude for everything that you currently have, because that's what you're going to build off going forward. And no matter where you are in your life right now, there are things that you have within your power that other people don't have. And we need to be grateful for that. What's your experience with sort of showing gratitude?
Gratitude is what I'm driven by, man. It's everything for me. And like we talked about in two episodes ago when we were talking about that David Foster Wallace speech, we were talking about how our minds are drawn to stories of fear. Our default mode is to think about how we're the center of the world and everything revolves around us and things are inconvenient, and to just get frustrated about that. And so building that habit of gratitude, of taking time to write down what you're grateful for, your mind has to do a little work because you actually have to think outside what might be the default mode. Okay, ooh, I should be grateful for that delicious dinner that I had yesterday. Whereas oftentimes maybe you just have dinner and then move on to the next thing. And so taking that time to pause, to think, and to build that habit of gratitude, I think is so powerful, because for me, it's really the driving force that motivates me in everything I do.
I'm thinking specifically to your example just about food, like that people don't even think about, like you know, how amazing is it that you go to a store and there's these perfectly packaged things that somewhere, you know, somebody somewhere in the world, you don't even know where they are.
It's unbelievable.
They took the time to go prepare this thing for you. They took somebody came up with a process to properly package this thing so it could get to you and
exactly.
still be fresh and in a presentable way. And then you're able to bring it home. And then we can use all of these tools that we didn't make. I don't know about
right.
you, but I didn't make my pan and my oven and my stovetop, but it's there. Somebody
made
it.
I don't know about you. I love that.
and then I could prepare this meal, you know,
yeah.
everything that goes into that. If I had to do all of those things myself, like I wouldn't be, you know, I wouldn't be getting real far every day. So
absolutely.
I think there's, when you start looking at the world that way and appreciating everything that you have, it really does change the lens and change the game.
Mm-hmm.
Those are the savers. So again, I'll hit them again. Savers, S-A-V-E-R-S, silence, affirmation, visualization, exercise, reading, and scribing. So that's going to be the foundation,
Boom.
The basis around which this challenge that Stiga has for you, that's going to be the basis, the container for this challenge moving forward. And this is going to provide you a really strong foundation to be able to move into the new year with some momentum starting today, starting now. And that I think, you know, over the long term, these will be little things you could do that are going to add up to that level 10 success that we talked about earlier in the episode. So Stig, hit him
yep.
with the challenge, my guy.
Before I get into the 30-day challenge, one thing I want to say real quick. Before the challenge, we really encourage you to find an accountability partner and tell them you are going to do this challenge and to hold you accountable, because it's the new year. And that first week, that second week, is going to be easy, right? The first 10, 15 days is going to be easy. But what happens when you're stressed at work, you got something on the schedule coming up, it's raining out? Sometimes you need that extra little bit of motivation, someone holding you accountable. So find an accountability partner. The second thing we encourage you to do to hold yourself accountable on this challenge, on our Instagram page, Go Get It Pod, we are going to be posting the challenge on our main feed. Head on over there and just drop a comment and say, I'm in. So we know that you're in. So we can hold you accountable as we are holding each other accountable, because you know Hunter and I are doing this challenge.
You know we're all over it. And I want to add one thing to that.
Oh, please.
The first person who drops I'm in the comments,
yes,
I'm gonna buy them a Miracle Morning book. I'm gonna send
Woo!
A Miracle Morning book to them. So I will DM the first person that says I'm in, and I will get your address, and I will send you a Miracle Morning book so you can get that in under your belt before you jump in there.
I love it. Okay, here is the 30-day challenge. For the next 30 days, you will start off your morning with this. Number one, make your bed. If you've been with us at the Go Get It podcast for a while, you've heard Make Your Bed as an episode. We didn't touch on it today, but it still is important. One, make your bed. Two, 1 minute of silence.
We gave you examples there on what that can be.
Number three, one affirmation. Tell yourself one affirmation. Number four, do 1 minute of visualization. Number five, 3 minutes of exercise. Number six, 3 pages of reading. And lastly, Number 7, write down 3 things you are grateful for. Now, we are going to drop all of those in the show notes. They're going to be on our Instagram page. Hunter and I are going to be posting them about them for the next 30 days. So if you need a reminder, if you need a refresher, you can go check that out. But all of this together takes about
10 minutes. 10, 15 minutes.
And here's the thing. Why not try? What do you have to lose?
Trust me, this will make a huge difference. 10 minutes a day. This is going to put you in power. This is going to put you in control. This is going to put you in a position of momentum and force and energy. And it's going to carry you through to becoming that level 10 version of yourself that you want to become, to attracting the level 10 success, the level 10 relationships, the level 10 health, the level 10 fitness. All of that starts with you taking control in your morning. So do not take this lightly. If you're into the challenge, say I'm in, and let's go get it together, people.
Go get it.